Pisces, what's good, you guys? Happy motherfucking birthday. It's your girl Jupiter here. I am a bit late. But I'm on time for some of you. Happy birthday. I miss you guys. Pisces, y'all the shit. We got this retrograde in Pisces that's whooping everyone's asses. I don't know if Pisces are our beaker right now to help us get through this shit. y'all let me know how y'all getting through this shit with it being in your sign and all. You know, everybody's like, oh, it's in Pisces, so it's taken away. It's time to reveal the disillusions. Like, oh, that ain't right. Anyways, you guys, I love you guys. Thank you all for returning, joining me, new people that have subscribed. Thank you all for your energy, your time, your love. Thank you for the thumbs up ahead of time. Thank you. Gracias. Okay. So, you guys, I'm going to get into this this reading because it's been a bit long. I explained in my other reading that I've been on a little hiatus because I was sick. Again. Yes, again. It's that season, y'all. It's that bullshit-ass season where motherfuckers get sick for breathing in air and shit. But, playing catch-up has been very dramatic for me because I just was sick. But anyways, let's see what's going on with y'all. Let's stay in the birthday energy. Woo! Okay. All right. And look at that. The Mercury retrograde called again. Again. Yes. So we have the second house owning. We have Black Moon Lilith mystery. And then we have Mercury retrograde reinvention. So this is a new deck for me. This is Black Moon. This is the Black Moon astrology deck. So I'm going to pull some current energies for you guys and see what's going on. And I'm also going to use Cardomancy. And see what's going down. Step right up, step right in. All right. So, you guys. Oh, you guys that are new here to my channel, I use Pandora Radio randomly selected songs to help me deliver the messages intuitively. I have Liberated by Dej Loaf. Okay. I think this is talking about loving yourself or some shit like that. Love yourself. Love yourself. Okay, so second house. Money and finances. I think you getting your shit together. Dollar bill, y'all. Y'all dollar billing it. Getting your money in order, getting your coins up, paying your bills. Some of you could be getting a raise at work, collecting a check. That income tax check could be coming in. This is about having some abundance come into you. Some well-deserved abundance. Because you've been working hard at it. You could be looking at buying some property, investing in some type of real estate. You could be your career could be taken off in some type of area, like some business venture that you were working on could be taken off. You're able to bring this elegance to your life because you have money. you're having money come in, so you're able to do more of the finer things that you like to do. Pisces, y'all about looking lavish, living lavish and beautiful, you know what I'm saying? Putting on the finest of things, doing the finer things in life, enjoying life, you know. It seems that I think you were in the past. Let me turn this shit down. It's just irritating. I think in the past you were, you may have cut people off. You may have done something. You it's like you took a stand for your energy. You took a stand for the energy that you were putting out. And then it's like you drew it back in. Like, you know, like, okay, let me, I need my sunshine back from you. I need my sunshine back from you. I need my sun rays from you. I need my love and light and my heat from you. It's like you just collecting all the love and light and energy and feel good that you pushed out to everybody. Because it's about getting your shit together. It's about you having the finer things. It's about what's important to you. And right now, your finances and your money and your career, those are all things that are really, really, really important to you. And I feel like Pisces, you all are like, you always think about other people. You're always trying to balance things out with people, even things out, give them emotion, make, you know, be there for people. And it's a bit draining. I know it has to be draining as fuck. But everybody sees you as that mature, respectable person that usually does that. You usually give people a peace of mind. People usually come to you for passionate, good advice because you have good intentions. So whatever advice you give is going to be some good fucking advice, and people know that. I think you've been protecting yourself. You've been protecting yourself from negativity, especially with you getting your money up, getting your coins up, and making sure that you are able to have the finer things in life, like, period. So, let's see what else is going on here, because we have Black Moon Lilith here. Oh, I'll pick the card up. So, as you can see, this card is about mystery. And what this card talks about is some type of, I don't know if somebody is feeling a lot of sexual tension, a lot of sexual energy, a lot of sexual fucking beams and fucking energy, like a lot of heavily sexual feelings. This could have an effect of highlighting your feminine energy within you, making you feel sexy, making you feel like, making you feel like, empowered, beautiful, respected. Maybe you guys weren't operating out of your femininity, and or maybe this is asking you to. feel that feminine energy more, or allow that feminine energy to come in more. You could be dealing with someone who's a bit bitchy, because they could be in this negative feminine energy. Negative only because, I mean, not necessarily negative, but I say negative because of the Six of Spades down here. So there was some type of misunderstanding, some type of situation that you may be trying to go through or get through with someone, or someone's trying to get through it with you, and they may be trying to use their sexual energy, or maybe this is you trying to use your sexual energy to kind of get through some type of obstacle or some type of problem that you may have had with someone or in the past or something. You have, I think from coming from this place of focusing on your home, your house, your finances, your money, your pinnacles, getting your money up, having a savings, investing it, being in that king shit energy where you're focusing, you're passionate, you're focusing on your money. I feel like it's like, okay, so now that was, okay, so we focused on money. We did that. And now this is coming in like, you know, it's like, you know, trying to get a little something, you know, trying to get a little something. It's like somebody has this sexual energy that they're thinking of, that they've been thinking of, or this sexual charge that's coming through to kind of bring you back to this feminine energy. Because over here, there's this masculine energy where you've been focusing on your money, you've been focusing on your home, investing, and being, you know, taking your light and your sunshine back, so to speak, from people around you. So you could put it all into your money and having the finer things and being blessed within your own success. Now this energy is coming through with Black Moon Lilith that's asking you to, or it's provoking you to be more your feminine energy, be more sensual. You could be really wanting to have sex right now. You could be really wanting to be with someone in a sexual way. This could be a air sign person, Aquarius, Gemini, Libra, or they could have that in their chart, or you could be wanting to communicate that with someone or to someone. You're constantly maybe thinking about having sex with somebody or being with them in some type of sexual way, or someone is thinking that way with you. Someone may see you as this feminine sexual goddess and they just can't wait to indulge and swallow you up. I feel like someone is trying to, or they want to be really aggressive towards having sex with you, or you want to have sex with someone. Either way, it's like, at one point it was like, okay, I'm focusing on my money, my house, investments. And then maybe the retrograde came in and was looking like sex. Shit, I want my pussy ate. I want my ass ate. I want my dick sucked. I want to get nasty. I want to do nasty. somebody trying to be nastier than a motherfucker. And I don't expect nothing else from Pisces. Pisces, when I did my favorite position survey, you guys were the biggest responders and supporters of that, and you guys have the most positions and most favorite positions in sex. Very specific. Very fucking specific. Like, I like to ride that dick and get my titty stuck with my hair being gently pulled. That's the type of responses that I got from Pisces. Like, yeah, grab my waist with one hand while you smacking my ass with the other one, while you gently thrusting from behind. Like some very specific shit. So this could be somebody in that very specificness. Like either they want to have this sex with my the amazing Pisces. Sex with me is so amazing, Rihanna. Shout out to Riri. But I know that's what you guys, y'all that water, y'all that fish. So the emotions, the love that y'all are able to push out to somebody and to give somebody is like no other. The love that someone will feel from you is like no other. Very sensual, very feminine. So someone could be thinking of that, or you could be thinking of that now that you've been completely about your pinnacles, completely about your money. So the retrograde comes in. Retrograde comes in and says, hey, I'm here to fuck shit up. I'm here to stop people from thinking of things that they shouldn't be thinking of. I don't really know exactly what the fuck that is, but maybe it's sex. So the retrograde comes in. And the retrograde says that, and it's in Pisces at that, so go figure. We have this here. Reinventing yourself. So you've had these problems, you've had these mishaps, these misunderstandings, you've had blow-ups, arguments with someone, some individual, or maybe within your own circle at work, or when it came to your money or sex, or some type of, there's some type of glitch here. There's something that was, that needs to be fixed, something that was broken, something that needs to be looked at in a, in, and fix. I don't know. We got the sixes here. So let's see. Pisces. So I think, okay. Somebody, whoever this resonates with, because I have a few different scenarios here. Someone left someone behind. Someone left somebody's ass in the cold because they were chasing that coin. They were chasing that dollar. Or they were chasing success, period. I don't want to say chasing money, because you gain so much more than just money. Like you gain clout. You gain success, true success. If you haven't, you're on your way to gaining true success. Someone got cut off because of the money move you was making. The move that you were making for self, like I said, you took your sunshine back. You're usually this person who's very giving, nurturing, mature about situations, and you took that back. You just use it all for yourself. Someone could be viewing you as very feminine and sexual because of your ability, the ability that you exercise to walk away from somebody, to pull your energy back that was sexy to somebody that meant you, that just showed, not only did they see your masculinity, but now they see the feminine, beautiful pleasure within you being able to have such a masculine decision-making, logical aspect on life,
or your money at least.
So it looks like you pull back from somebody, or someone pulled back from you. Either way, they lost your company. You left them, or they left you, but someone wants to now come back and redo it, like redo the situation. Because of the mishaps, because of the arguments, because of everything that may have brought you apart, or, you know, been some type of negative betrayal in the past, this person now wants to make things right. Now, this energy could be y'all. Y'all know the energy is very interchangeable. So please take what resonates, leave the rest, leave it all, use for entertainment purposes, live your life. So it seems that someone cut some bullshit out their life, and now that bullshit kind of wants to come back around and fuck the shit out of you. in other words. But that looks like that to be one situation. Now, the other situation, I think you may have saw someone for being the jackass that they were. Like you've taken off those rose colored glasses. You've stepped off of this pedestal of, oh, maybe that's not the right way to put it, but it's like you came out of hiding, or I'm trying to find a different way of saying it, but let's just say you took the veil off your eyes, period. You took the blindfold off your eyes. You took the veil off your eyes. You see now more of things being what they are. Like, you know you pulled your energy back for a reason to get your money up. You could be feeling like a sexy beast yourself for doing that. Or just having success now. Now you feel sexy. You feel... You have both of your polarities balanced out right now. The retrograde could be coming in and just showing you how good, how much of a good decision that was for you. Because this decision also cut someone out, X someone out. It cut someone out your life. Now this person could be sitting back wishing and dreaming and hoping and thinking that they can be sexually active with you again, or maybe just period. Someone lost you though. Someone is either losing you because of the retrograde, because you're now seeing, like, why do I, if you're taking the veil off your eyes and you're seeing things clearly, you're seeing things for what they really are. So why did I invest all this time into this? Now that you're completely balanced out, you don't see why you invested time into this. You're ready to reinvent yourself. You're ready to redo things. As well as someone else ready to and wanting to redo them with you or something. Somebody wants to communicate because we have these sixes here. And then we have Insecure by Bryson Tiller and Jasmine Sullivan. I could take a lot of shit, but I won't take that. Don't you know the trust is important? So you could have been dealing with somebody who didn't trust you, who was very insecure. And you basically reigned supreme on that ass. Like, I'm taking my energy back. I'm taking my power back. I'm taking my love. I'm taking my sex. I'm taking my pussy. I'm taking my dick. I'm taking it all back because it's mine at the end of the day. And you doing that has balanced yourself out. But somebody really wants to communicate with you to solve this problem. Because not only did a retrograde come in through for you, it came through for them too, to make them see that maybe they fucked up, they did something wrong, they should have said something to you before, but they didn't. They let it get to this retrograde period to where now they are being forced to feel the need to fix something, rectify a situation. But you having logic and femininity, masculine and feminine, you have the polarities balanced out to where you know, your intuition knows that this person lost you for a reason. Because there's this deep fucking loss here. There's this deep loss because someone is realizing that they really lost you. Or maybe you're realizing that you really want to walk away and lose somebody. Like, you trying to lose somebody and you realize, like, damn, you wasn't what I thought you was. You wasn't, this was, the situation wasn't what I thought it was. It's not what I thought it would be. This is not what I signed up for. I'm cool on you. I'm cool on it. I'm cool on this. And this could be just you realizing how much you don't need this very specific relationship that you lost, or someone lost you once again. But this person is definitely feeling the need to communicate to you. They feel that you switched up on them because you were on a journey. You were doing something a long time ago. You were focused on your pinnacles. You were focused on getting your money up and setting a career path, investing in property, going to school, upgrading your crafts, to be able to have more and lavish and the finer things in life, because that's what you just set your goal to, that to have the finer things, to have more in your life. And that cut out a lot of people, and a lot of people are not happy about that. So the retrograde says that you did a good job, bitch. So don't listen to them haters. And for this person who lost you, they're going to be sad. You're going to probably, if you're not feeling their energy, especially within this retrograde, because they really pulling on the kid. They like, please talk to me. I need to talk to you. Because you're exuding, you're pushing off this heavy sexual feminine energy. Even if you're a man, you're pushing off big dick energy. To where this person over here, whoever lost you, are sitting back thinking like, damn, this person has never been this sexy before in my life. I see this person's sexiness truly, not because, oh, they got a little waist and a big booty, or they got a big dick, but because this person knows how to get their money. They know how to make money moves. They know how to invest. Not only are you getting money and having fun with it, but you're investing. So that puts you ahead of the people that just collect a check and go out every Friday, Saturday night or whatever, and they go get a nice outfit, they go get their hair, nails done, whatever. This is you doing that, having these moments of just having fun with yourself. Maybe you're taking yourself out. Maybe you're not going out on a Friday, Saturday night. Maybe you're going out on a Friday or a Saturday, and you're just enjoying your day out, period. Maybe it's a beach day. Maybe it's a shopping day. Either way, you're doing things for yourself. You're setting time aside for self. And then you're turning around and seeing where you need to invest and put your money in certain areas that'll gain and be a passive income for yourself. So I hope this resonates. It's definitely a different reading than I've had before, because I have these different cards, so they're pretty cool. You guys, I love y'all. Happy birthday. Hop in my comments. Let me know if this resonates. Talk to me. Say hi to me. Speak to me. Love me, okay? Pisces, I love the fuck out of y'all. Happy birthday again. Happy belated birthday, you guys. I miss you so much. Thank you again. I'll talk to y'all soon.